It's the Zach Sang Show. We are backstage at the AMAs, and I'm with BTS.
You're with BTS. Yeah,
and it's an honor to be with you guys.
Oh, it's an honor to, you know, like, be here.
Is it really? I mean, this is beyond a dream, because I feel like you guys, your dream to perform and to eventually become idols, right?
Right.
But to crack Western pop culture, it's really never been done.
Yeah, since it's radio, you can't. I don't know if you guys can't see our face or something, but we cannot still believe it. I mean, like, it's still unbelievable for us.
What was your dream growing up? Like, when you first realized that you wanted to sing, like, what was your end goal? What did you want to see yourself do?
Go to the Billboard.
Yeah, go to the
Billboard.
I made it.
Get on the Billboard charts.
Yeah.
I mean, it's pretty insane.
Yeah, it's a dream for everyone, every artist.
You guys are doing it not just by creating incredible music, right? You're working with Steve Aoki, you're working with Designer, but your music embodies change and it fuels change, right? It's about the belief of the next generation of our world.
You feel that?
It's special.
Thanks,
dude.
Thanks for saying that.
It really does. It gives me goosebumps.
Oh, really?
Just the fact that here in America, we're embracing lyrics that are solely in Korean.
Right.
You're proving that music is without borders.
Music truly transcends languages. We believe that.
And when you come up with your lyrics, I mean, it's fueled by your own life. Like, you've released songs about,
right,
you know, going to school and being turned into studying machines.
That's correct. I mean, you know us.
Do you feel like that's a risky move, trying to create those types of conversations?
That's truly... Like you said, it can be a risky move, but, you know, like, if somebody got to say that, I think it should be us, you know, like, why don't we say that? Like, somebody needs to say about those topics, right?
They do.
Yeah, except parties, or, you know, parties are good, but still, we need to talk about school, you know, like something like that.
Do you feel pressure being in your position and being idolized by so many?
You know, it would be a lie if we don't
sometimes
feel, yeah, any pressure. 말해줘, 형. 말하고 싶은 거 있으면.
아, 그냥 가끔씩 느끼지만 우리가 우리니까 할 수 있는 이야기를 하는 거죠, 뭐.
So he said basically we're saying that there are some stories that only we can tell. He thinks that there are some stories that only BTS can tell, so we just tell him about it.
Because you're the only people who can tell it, it's worth the pressure that comes along with the job that you've signed up for.
It's worth the pressure, and I can say that our fans, ARMY, like, they are proving it was not wrong.
I mean, this journey isn't an easy one, right? The idea that you walk out and you now have security with you, and you've released, you know, your first real body work was back in 2013, and you've been socially charged since the beginning.
Right, we got nothing at that time.
Yeah, but you laid the groundwork for what BTS is now. It is hard, right, to walk in your shoes? I mean, it is with fame and really cool clothes and great music, but
it's just the thing, you know?
It's
just the outlet.
It's material.
Yeah, it's material.
Well, you guys write about often, too. You know, that material is just material. How do you cope? How do you stay in touch with yourselves as individuals throughout this entire thing?
약간 겉과 다른 속이 약간 어떤 다른 이런 그런 모순에 대해서 어떻게 느끼는지 슈강이나 호비가 말해주면 좋을 것 같은데 뭐 약간 이제 이런 우리가 겉 뭐 모순들이나 이렇게 하면서 힘들었던 시절들이나
뭐 크게 그때랑 달라진 거는 별로 없는데 뭐랄까 그냥 계속해서 그냥 우리는 우리 걸 하고 있는데 많은 사람들이 사랑해 주시니까 거기에 대해서 약간의 그 신기함과 놀라움을 가지고 있지만 막 그게 부정적이지는 않는 것 같아요.
He said not actually, you know, exactly not much things have changed. You know, we were doing our own things at that time in 2013 and we're still doing it in 2017. But many people, he said he's thankful, you know, because many people feeling it, loving it.
Yeah.
And now we are here.
Yes, you are.
Yeah.
Can we talk about your work with UNICEF?
Oh, yeah.
Please?
Thanks for saying that. We're so we're doing a campaign called BTS Love Myself.
Yeah.
Love Myself campaign. So it's like. It's related with end violence campaign because I think BTS words and lyrics have a serious relationship with all the violences in the world.
Yes.
So we're doing that, and I hope that, you know, people reminds this word on myself, you know, because of this campaign, and I hope they can love themselves more. That's it.
I think that's a really a needed reminder that I think a lot of people forget.
Thank you.
How do you remind yourselves to love yourselves as individuals and not as BTS? Like, what is it?
자신을 사랑하는 방법이 혹시 있을까요?
You can answer.
남이랑 비교하면 안 됩니다. 그거는 정말 맞는 말이에요.
자기가 하고 싶은 것을 하면서 자기 것을 찾아가는 게 가장 가까운 방법이 아닌가 싶어요.
So Suga said, please don't compare to yourself to others. And J-Hope said, I'm finding my, try to find my dreams and, you know, something that I really want to achieve is the best way to love myself. Yeah. And I think, you know, simply, just tell yourself, you know, call your name. If you're, well, I'm sorry, what was your name?
Zach.
Zach, is that right?
Yeah.
So if I'm Zach, I'll tell myself, like, Zach, you're doing just great. Zach, I love you.
Zach, is this, I love
yeah,
you.
Yeah, is it, you know,
Zach,
like,
doing,
yeah, yeah.
I need
you're hitting your shoulders. Yeah, three times a day.
Okay.
I mean, that can change yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah, I believe that. So I'm really doing it to myself.
Cool.
Yeah, it's just a simple start.
Love it. Truly, truly.
Yeah, Zach, you're doing great.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, thanks for telling that.
Designer Steve Aoki, mic drop, right? That's going to be, you know, the big single. Does anybody in the group have a goal of learning English fluently?
영어 공부하고 싶은 멤버 있나요 혹시?
Of course.
Yeah.
Me.
A B C D E F G.
You're close. This is the beginning yeah. start. Yeah.
Wow. I mean, I want to tell about these members' developments. Since it's radio station, they cannot say many things, but they tried to memorize some words for this series interview, and yeah they just I think they're practicing. They're studying.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And I mean, I just keep. When you release music, my ask is keep using Korean lyrics. I think what you're doing with music and how you're connecting people no matter where they are in the world and realizing that one person's struggle on one side of the globe is the same as somebody's struggle here, it's a big deal.
So it is a big deal.
You're doing a lot of good. Truly.
Thank you.
Truly.
Thank you.
We're so consoled.
It's very cool.
Thanks.
Hey, appreciate all of you guys.
Appreciate you.
Thank you for your work with UNICEF as well. I mean, right now you're at like $450,000 raised so far to help, you know, make the world a safer place for people our age.
I mean, I think you're the first one to, you know, ask about it. So, like, we're so, you know, touched by that.
You guys.
Thanks.
Please come to the studio. You have a fan in us, truly. And you have incredible fans, too. I got to thank them. I mean,
they are.
Getting the questions and their interest in you guys and their love for all of you. It's really, it's... I've been doing this a while, and I've never really seen anything like it. So it's really special.
They are.
Truly.
And you are, too.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, thank you.
Love BTS. Yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you.
We love Zach. Thank you.
My hand's a little sweaty. Sorry.